Greetings and welcome to another LGR Quickie Review. Today, we're going to be looking at Digital Cyber Cherry's new retro arcade Neon, which actually came out in the latter part of 2016. The developer sent me a code for it a while back. I'm just now getting around to it. And what is it, you may ask? It is a fancy 3D front end made in the Unreal Engine that lets you explore and customize a virtual 1980s arcade rec room experience of sorts, or 90s, or whatever else you want to do, because the whole name of the game here is customization. But again, this is not a game, it's a front end. And if you're familiar with a lot of emulation, then you probably have looked into different front-end programs, which is meant to make exploring your game collection a lot easier. So it's usually just a selection of 2D menus. They usually look pretty nice, but this is all in 3D. So, and it's in first person, which makes it very much ideal for virtual reality. So it makes use of the HTC Vive, the Oculus Rift, and of course you can play it not in VR if you really don't want to do that. Just grab a random 2D computer monitor and explore the 80s, that's fine. But it really does shine in virtual reality because of the whole, you know, sense of presence and immersion and all the VR stuff that makes sense. And this one is done very well. In fact, it's probably the best room customizer, for lack of a better term, that I've seen in VR so far. Not just because it's graphically impressive and it's a subject matter that just highly appeals to me as a retro gamer, but also because it has some pretty awesome sound design. It sounds believable with the 3D positional audio going on, the reverb and things like that. Just listen to this. And while I'm able to talk about this due to a very generous donation from Kenneth, thank you, sir. It actually comes together in a way that, man, it feels cool. This is a really neat little program. So yeah, this is not just a single player experience. You can have up to 5 other people join you, so 6 people total can wander around in this arcade with you. Although, there's a bit of a limitation there because they can't actually play the arcade games at all. And they're going to be stuck playing the other things, the side activities, mini games, whatever you want to call them. And there's like 10 or so of them. You got like a skee ball, bowling, darts, air hockey, basketball, even an Etch-a-Sketch, a little electric guitar, and a robot, and all sorts of clutter objects lying around, which is pretty neat. You've got a stereo that you can put cassette tapes into it, and a VCR, you can put VHSs into that, and these things are all pretty much customizable. And that's the thing, you've got to customize this stuff yourself. You're not going to have much of any of this pre-configured except for like the radio and a little bit of the video stuff. The video links to like YouTube and Vimeo and whatnot, the VHS tapes, and then the cassette tapes are just internet radio stations. That's easy enough. Copy and paste the link, you're done. Everything else, like arcade games, the consoles, the handhelds, all these kind of things that you probably really want to mess around with, is going to have to be done in that external program. And that program doesn't actually let you test these things as you're configuring them. So, for instance, if you're trying to get some sort of arcade machine working or a Game Boy or whatever, then you're going to have to put it all in there, hope that it works, start new retro arcade up, navigate over to where the machine is, try it out, and then hope it doesn't crash, which there's a good chance it will because I don't even know. Emulation is weird. You have to find your own emulation cores, got to find your own ROMs, you got to find your own artwork for the cabinets and the cartridges, you got to customize the attract screens. It's just like there's every single little piece is not there, just the framework. And granted, it's a very nice looking and effective framework, but if you're into this for the arcade machines and the consoles and handhelds and whatnot, there's a lot of work to do. Even if you download somebody else's arcade, just pre-made off of the Steam forums or Reddit or something, it's probably not going to come with the ROMs and other things like that anyway. So you're still having to customize it no matter what. It's $20, which, yeah, that's on the edge of what I would recommend paying for it, depending on what you're into and what you really want to do, since there's so much setup needed. But still, when it all comes together, it's such a cool experience. There's also not as much in terms of physical interaction of a lot of little objects and stuff that I've seen in other similar-ish VR programs, like Pool Nation VR, which is now, I guess, Sports Bar VR. With that, you could pick up bottles and break them and throw chairs and knock over jukeboxes and just pretty much if you could see it, you could pick it up and throw it or something. in New Retro Arcade Neon, there's a lot of objects that either they don't break or act how you'd think that they would, or they're just like stuck there. Like you're not gonna be able to just, I don't know, throw a pizza at someone, like, even though it's right there. Or you look inside of a little cooler and you see a can, you want to pick it up, but you can't. It's just a static object. About the only other thing that I really wish for at this point was being able to customize the layout of the room or just anything like that. You can pretty much just mess with anything within the framework that already exists. But yeah, beyond that, you're not going to be able to like move a machine from one location to another or even move a chair. Or like, I don't like that pizza box there, I'm going to put it over there. You can't do that. It's all baked into this map in Unreal Engine, and the lighting is baked in and all this stuff. So apparently that's just not very feasible. And that would require a much more advanced editor anyway. But I think it's possible in VR. It would just require a lot of extra stuff that this does not do right now. But for what it does do, I think it's darn fascinating, and it's definitely worth a look if you have a VR headset and like the 80s, man, and 90s kind of nostalgic retro stuff, and want something neat to immerse yourself in and just customize to your heart's content. If you like that stuff and getting your hands dirty, this is pretty neat. And if you enjoyed this video, then thanks! I've got other ones. You can watch them here. And you can also check back every Monday and Friday for more. And as always, thank you very much for watching.